Hello, does anyone actually like black licorice? It just seems pointless, like garnish or Miss USA, you know? It's nice to look at, but there's not much else there. Anyway, comment down below whether you like black licorice or not, because I've genuinely never met someone who does, ever. So today's video was going to be about Noah's Ark, but then Britain left the European Union and $2 trillion was wiped off the world's wealth and Ariel Winter broke up with her boyfriend. I don't know who she is either, but according to Google, she's just as important. Seriously, the amount of people searching that was the same amount of people searching European Union and Brexit. 2016. Good job, guys. Well done. In all honesty, I'm actually surprised that the EU referendum even happened. Surely after watching X Factor, it's obvious that the British public shouldn't be allowed to vote. Just look at how far Jedward got through. They look like Q-tips. Used Q-tips.
What is going on here?
Brexit.
Anyway, this video isn't about my opinion or what I think should have happened. I just want to discuss what has happened following the result, such as Nigel Farage admitting that the basis for the Leave campaign was about as real as Donald Trump's hair. Not political, it's just hair. He has backtracked on some huge promises, and it seems like a decisive margin of people who voted Leave have since changed their minds. Which sucks for them. But it's like the end of a relationship, you know, when you break up with your boyfriend or girlfriend. So Britain's gonna go out and have a few drinks, and before you know it, it's gonna be leaving a few drunk messages on France's answering machine wanting to get back together. But France isn't having any of that shit. France remembers back in 1973 when Britain kept asking to join the Union but kept getting rejected until finally they were allowed in. But now Britain wants to be single, and France feels like that this analogy has gone on for too long. Way too long. Countries aren't even sentient. It doesn't make sense. You know what else doesn't make sense? How divided the country has become. Since the referendum, there's been a lot of hostility from both sides. It's called the United Kingdom, not the Divided Kingdom, so we should unite. Find a common ground and move forward and try to find the best possible future for everyone, rather than just shouting, "My opinion is better than your opinion." Chances are your opinion is just like riding a two-wheeled hoverboard through the city centre. You think it's awesome, but to everyone else, you look like a bit of a dick. But hey, that's just my 2 cents, which in England is now worth £157. So, economic comedy. Seriously though, the value of sterling did drop significantly, which was terrifying. Also terrifying, Germany has declared revenge on Britain, which is terrifying because the last time Germany declared revenge on a group of people, Anne Frank wrote a diary. Which, to be fair, I have been waiting for a sequel, so who knows. But before I go, I would like to mention that it seems like a lot of people who voted Remain are calling those who voted Leave racist and bigots, and that everything's gonna be shit now. Which isn't fair, because for a lot of people who voted Leave, things possibly already are very shit. They most likely aren't racist and just voted for a drastic change because the current situation was not benefiting them in the slightest. And it's best to push for a brighter future than stay in a shitty past. Saying that, I feel like the people spearheading the Leave campaign were doing it for the wrong reasons. It shouldn't be about nationalistic pride or getting your country back or whatever. I've never understood that. For any country in the world, I do not understand nationalism at all. But if you're proud of being British, think back to about 70 years ago, our country was beaten by a dude who just didn't eat. Britain lost to a guy because he went on a diet. Congratulations. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. This is my Snapchat, add me, and such. I leave you now with a dramatic reenactment I made about the European Union. I'll see you next week. Goodbye.
Oh, won't you stay?